Home project, we were working closely with the BBC to create a piece of almost interactive and immersive theatre surrounding what it would actually be like to do a spacewalk.
It came about through actually a conversation with Tim Peake, and he was talking about one of the experiences he enjoyed the most. It was an emergency training scenario, but an emergency training scenario that he was incredibly good at. And we sort of said, well, hang on a minute, actually this is potentially a wonderful chance to explore how VR as an experiential medium can help somebody learn. It can potentially be an inspiring thing, giving somebody the opportunity to live out their dream. And also, I guess, from a story and a creative craft point of view, we can start to really explore and push at what the medium and VR in particular can do.
We were looking to push the boundaries of that ability to cross the border from being a form of entertainment to being a life experience.
One of the problems we had to consider was how you actually traverse around the ISS. In space, obviously, if you push against a handle or a surface, you would just completely float off. So we had to try and design a system that was accessible for all that. So it gives the feeling that you are weightless, but you do actually have a purpose.
If you want to spend 15 minutes literally climbing around the outside of the station, you can do that. But we always designed the narrative as a kind of a rubber band narrative. So there are two fixed points and you can kind of deviate as far as you want, but it'll always bring you back to that next point of the narrative.
We also built the project entirely to scale. So the Earth itself is actually the correct one-to-one size. Nothing is cheated, which did actually cause a few issues in production, working on sort of scene scales that large. But Unreal allowed us to work like that. So it meant that we could actually recreate a lot of the lighting effects and a lot of the physics.
UE4 as an engine for us gives a higher level of fidelity and polish to projects early on. We ended up having to create, I think it's about a quarter of the Earth, takes up most of the world space, so that when you look down out of the space station, the visual distance to the Earth is correct. It gives you that real sense of scale, and then we have to bring in, on top of that, like cloud layers and weather and the lighting. UE4 gave us the ability to map all of the Earth that you could potentially see from the space station in the real game space.
We actually got the chance to put two astronauts in it recently in New York, both of which came out going, wow, that's quite profound. We're really pleased with that, not least because it falls so wonderfully into kind of the BBC's Inform, Educate and Entertain.